Are you using the Flux models and finding that your performance is insufficient or you cannot use them at all because you lack the necessary memory? Do not worry, you are in the right place. In this video, I will show you how to use the Flux models effortlessly even with less VRAM by employing GGUF models. You will learn everything from installation to setting up an efficient GGUF workflow, along with valuable tips. Be sure to watch the video until the end to not miss anything. Let's get started. Before we begin the installation, let me briefly explain the relationship between GGUF models and Flux. GGUF is a specialized file format designed to optimize large AI models, such as those from the Flux family, for efficient use on devices with limited hardware resources. By using techniques like quantization, GGUF reduces the memory, VRAM requirements of these models while maintaining high performance. Flux models, when converted to the GGUF format, are tailored to run smoothly on systems with constrained computational power, such as laptops or older hardware. This makes them an excellent choice for users seeking powerful AI functionality without needing high-end hardware. Now that you understand how GGUF enhances the usability of Flux models, let's proceed with the installation. When you click on the ComfyUI GGUF download link in my description below, you will find a document that I have put together just for you. It contains all the useful links and information you need. First, you will find my Patreon link here, where you can become a paid member if you would like to support me. As a thank you, you will receive exclusive workflows for download, including the one from today's video. This saves you time, as you can simply download it instead of creating it yourself. Additionally, you will get access to upscalers, facefix, control net for GGUF models, and much more. Next, you will find the link to my Discord server, where you can ask questions if you encounter any issues or engage in discussions with others. Lastly, you will see the installation section for the GGUF models. Click on the link provided, which will redirect you to the GitHub page. Click here first on code at the top and download the zip file. This will give you the GGUF nodes, which you need to extract and move into the custom nodes folder. Once that is done, return to the document, scroll all the way down, and you will see dev GGUF, Schnell GGUF, and T5 encoder. We will open these one by one. First, go to Flux Dev, click on Files and Versions, and you will see various models ranging from Q2 to Q8 and F16. The higher the number, the more specific features can be generated in the image, and the better the image quality will be, but it will also require more VRAM. The same applies to the Schnell models. For the T5 encoder GGUF models, is the principle also the same, but it ranges from Q3 to F32. In my opinion, Q8 is the best choice, but Q6 is also very good. The creator recommends Q5 or higher for optimal results. You should decide which model best suits your needs. The more specific your requirements are, the higher the model should be. It is best to start with Q6 or Q8, and if your system cannot handle it, switch to Q5 or lower. Later in the video, I will provide some image and performance comparisons between a few models to give you a point of reference. Install and move the Dev and Schnell models into the ComfyUI Models UNet folder. After that, you need just to place the T5 encoder into the clip folder within the models directory, and you are ready. After you have downloaded all the necessary files, we will return to ComfyUI. If you are a paying member on Patreon, you can easily download the workflow from my supporter workflow document and import it into ComfyUI. This way, you will have the GGUF workflow immediately and also the GGUF ControlNet workflow directly available. For everyone else, I will now explain how to build the workflow yourself. First, double-click on the empty area and search for UNet Loader GGUF. Once you have added this, also create the Dual Clip Loader GGUF and load VAE. Then delete the load checkpoint and move the new elements to your starter workflow. Next, connect model to model, clip to clip, and VAE to VAE. If you have difficulties at this point or do not know the other nodes and the basic workflow, I recommend watching my video series on ComfyUI to better understand what is happening here. As for the case sampler, I will leave these settings as they are. You can adopt them as is or experiment yourself if you wish. We will set the image size to 1024 by 1024 pixels and specify that one image will be generated. In the unit Loader GGUF, select the downloaded model, for example, the Dev Q5. In the Dual Clip Loader GGUF, select the downloaded encoder, such as the encoder Q5. Once you have done that, you only need the prompt. I have already prepared a prompt, which we will use for the positive prompt. Oh, and do not forget to set the type to Flux in the Dual Clip Loader. Once you have set everything up, you can press Q at the bottom and the image will be generated. The image generation time time varies for everyone. For me, with the model, it took about 300 seconds. This time, for demonstration purposes, I used an RTX 3080 with 10GB and 32GB RAM. As you can see, we got a good image right away with the Q5 dev model, which looks very realistic, exactly what we want. Now let's switch to Q5 Schnell. I will skip the generation process. As we can see, the image has lower quality than the other image from the dev model, but it is generated faster and consumes slightly fewer resources. The Schnell GGUF model is optimized for fast generations, although the image quality suffers a bit. It also requires significantly fewer steps, about 4 steps, compared to dev, which makes it much faster. The dev GGUF model is slower because it requires more steps, about 20 steps. The longer computation time results in more precise and detailed images, which is especially beneficial for complex prompts. If you like the video so far, please leave a like and do not forget to subscribe for more videos like this one. Let us now move on to the comparison of the different models. For this purpose, I generated several images using the same seed to highlight the differences. First, let's take a closer look at the quality of the images. As you can clearly see with the dev models of the Q series, the image quality is nearly identical and shows little to no variation. However, compared to the Q series models, the original dev model appears overall better. It looks more of higher quality. A similar conclusion can be drawn for the Schnell Q series compared to the original Schnell model. Here too, the Q series models do not differ from each other. Nevertheless, it is evident that the original Schnell model delivers better quality than the Q series models. An important point regarding the Q models is that they do not show noticeable quality differences among themselves, even at lower Q levels. There is no significant quality drop in the smaller Q models, as long as they are suited to the intended task. However, it can happen that a lower Q model fails to generate certain content correctly because it was not trained adequately for it. In such cases, you should try generating the same image using a higher GGUF model trained with more data. This will allow you to determine whether the additional training data is necessary. For many applications, though, a smaller model is sufficient as it uses less computational power without causing significant quality losses. However, if you aim to achieve the best possible quality, there are specially trained models available on platforms like Civet AI, which may deliver even better results. It is worth trying out these models if you want to get the most out of your GGUF models. I also made a test using a more complex prompt to better highlight the differences between the Q models of the Schnell and Dev series, as well as the original models. I observed that the more specific and complex my prompt was, and the lower the level of the model, the more errors occurred. These errors often included incorrectly generated details like fingers or feet and omitted elements from the prompt. If you pause the video and take a closer look at the generated images, you can clearly see these generation errors in the Q models, both in comparison to the original models and within the Q series itself. Of course, you always have the option to regenerate an image until it works. However, with more complicated prompts, it quickly becomes apparent that a lower Q model often struggles to produce the desired results. In such cases, you should try using a higher GGUF model that has been trained with more data. Alternatively, you can turn to models available on platforms like Civet AI, as these are specifically optimized and may deliver better performance. Let's now take a look at the generation times. For this video, I'm using an RTX 3080 with 10GB of VRAM and 32GB of RAM. Let's start with the dev models. Q4, 38.50 seconds. Q6, 48.63 seconds. Q8, 44.44 seconds. F16, 61.68 seconds. Now moving on to the Schnell models. Q4, 40.50 seconds. Q6, 48.60 seconds. Q8, 44.39 seconds. F16, 61.81 seconds. These results show impressively short generation times. For comparison with my 4070 Ti Super, I achieve approximately 70 seconds per image when working with the original models. This highlights just how efficient the tested models are. And with that, the video is now coming to an end. If you haven't watched my latest ComfyUI videos yet, check out my playlist or my latest video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.